In this Radio 3 series, Kiri's 20 Favourite Voices, Dame Kiri to Kanawa chooses the singers she loves and tells us why, illustrating her choices with music and experiences from her life and her career.
Renata Tebaldi, a glorious, glorious voice, one of these singers that I wanted to include in this list. Tebaldi, I think I did see her in person, but never really talked to her or anything. She was at the Metropolitan Opera. She was grand, grand lady. And she would come in with the lights just dimmed because the audience knew that she was coming in. So, of course, she would come in just as they dimmed, and then that all the audience would stand to and applaud her. No matter what opera it was, she came in and sat in the front row or wherever she sat. And she knew that she'd get the whole audience up and standing and applauding, and they loved her so much, which was amazing in America. Tebaldi's voice had this glorious pathos. She could make you cry in a second. I found that that was very encouraging, that if I wanted to make people cry, or I felt it, you always have to feel that. You can't just make people cry because you think they should. She had that particular sound that made it like it was the last moment of life, the lights are going down, your life is coming to an end, or whatever it was. But she had that sound that I never ever copied, but I thought that was the sound that made me feel that if I could get that into my singing and make people love what I did or listen to what I did, get people's attention, and I felt she got my attention a lot. She was just a stunning, you know, I haven't listened to her more than 30 years now, which is, I always leave some of these recordings, but in fact, I will go back and have another listen and see what I did here in those days. But with Tebaldi, the Puccini was particularly beautiful. I mean, of course, you know, Italians can do that sort of thing. It's in their blood, isn't it? Before they're even born, I think they can sing Puccini. There was something very special, and and something that we know every time someone says about a voice, and her voice immediately springs to mind, that that's the voice, that if I would listen to a voice, I'd listen to that.